Why would you cut off all contact? Any normal person would just say, like, no, I'm with someone or whatever, and I'll make the song and make the music. Like, that's the part I don't get. Like, all these people on some fuck shit and then keep trying to proclaim it. Like, I mean, right now you going on a meaningless, senseless road trip for no fucking reason, and all y'all got empty ass lives. Like, live your life. You know what I mean? You ain't got to speak my name. We don't talk about you. You know what I mean? Like, you can't sing anyway. You trash. Like, on some real shit, if you want me to be real, I was just trying to be nice and do you a favor. Like, you can't be nice to none of these people. That's all I've seen and all they've shown me. When it comes to these bitches, don't even waste your time, dog. They're a waste of time. All of them. These aren't fucking girls. They're demons. You know what I mean? Look at this fucking one, fucking dancing in the mirror all day, talking to herself, doing weird demonic shit with her legs and shit and tits. You know what I mean? Looking like a straight up whore, talking about, I'm not gonna have a baby, I plan to have a baby. So you're telling us that you plan to fuck. Like, we really need to know that. Like, this is what bitches do today, bro. Like, I want to show the hypocrisy and the fucking, like, level of insanity in bitches today. Like, these bitches is nuts. They are not women. You cannot call yourself a girl. Y'all have no rights. You can't have human rights if you're not a human. Fact. So when all you people wanted to hate on Tyrese Neen and say my fucking name and have my name in your mouth, and keep wanting to hate and claim you so crazy and all y'all got mental issues, that bitch on medication too, FYI. And while all y'all wanted to do that shit, hey, I'm gonna take full advantage of that. Cause see, that shit all come back. It's called karma. What goes around comes around. Cry me a river, cry me a river, oh, oh, oh. You know? Yeah, y'all just don't seem to get the point, dog. When you sit there and you keep proclaiming that you're crazy and it's cool, all y'all broke, fucked up, your life fucked up, like that bitch miserable. She on camera every day screaming, crying, you know what I mean? They won't leave me alone! Ah! Oh, every fucking day, dog.
I'm depressed this day. I want to blow my brains out today. I hate my husband today. I'm fighting a neighbor today.
Like, every day it's a fucking catastrophe. Like, that's you people. A bunch of fucking problems. You know what I mean? Do you think I would want those fucking problems? Do you really think I would want to inherit those problems? You know what I mean? Like, it just doesn't make any sense. Like, yeah, I'm trying to fuck everything that walks. Of course, I am fucking everything that walks. What is your point? Like, that's my question. What is your point? You know what I mean? Because, like, it'd be cute if, like, you were single and you were on your video saying, like, no, it's not Tyrese's baby, but you ain't even single. Like, you're supposedly engaged or married, and it's all fake, and it's staged, and it's clear it is, and it's clear you have a fake life, and that you're not loyal to anyone, and you don't have a real relationship. You never make videos with your husband. Like, I would encourage you to be a real woman and pay attention to your fucking fake husband. How about that? Like, I feel sorry for the poor guy, because you don't even give him any attention. You don't make no videos with him. You don't involve him in nothing you do. You literally go to these people's houses, and you change, like, spouses, like, every 5 seconds. Like, you bitches is fucking retarded, bro. Straight up. They fucking retarded, and then all they want is, like, trying to create a situation where they can get attention on themselves to try to pretend that they pussy is worth something because they know it's worth nothing and that they have no worth. Because they have no worth themselves because they have a mental problem because most of them got molested as children because your fucking people happen to rape their fucking kids all the time. Fact. Talk about that. Huh? Talk about that. Then you want to call people fucking names for pointing out the truth. Nah, you Mexicans beat up your bitches and rape your fucking children. That's what you do. That's how you get down. Fuck you talking about. The only woman beaters is you fucking Mexicans. Straight up. You don't like it? Stick a pipe in it, bitch. I don't give a fuck. You know what I mean? All I'm saying is, like, why does everyone have my name in their mouth? And it's great, because all it's going to do is help us promote and keep blowing up, ain't it? So thank you. See, when bitches claim they play you, they don't play you. They play themselves. Use that to your advantage, because they just did you the biggest favor they can ever do for you, because they proved you the truth, that everyone full of shit. I don't need nobody. I stand on my own. I'm a motherfucking man. The girl that ends up with me will be the luckiest girl alive. Facts. And that's what happens when you believe in yourself and you don't judge your self-worth off of bitches. Because I want you to look at some, because all these bitches are with broke-ass peasants. And I'm going to tell you why, because what I learned in my experience, because I actually have it and lived real life while all y'all trying to make fun of people for living real life and learning through experience, what I did and had the heart to do, and you won't because you have no self-worth and you're not tough like me and you can't take the fucking licks and keep ticking like I did. I want you to prove to me you can live real life. I want you to prove to me that you can go broke a million times and keep coming back and get richer. I want you to prove to me that you can do that. I want you to prove to me that you can be an entrepreneur because none of you can do it. I want you to prove to me that you can do motivational speaking like me. I want you to prove to me that you can fucking go through what I've been through and come out harder. Because everybody mad right now and frustrated and want to kill themselves because I keep coming back stronger and harder and harder and better and better. Facts. So like I said, don't worry about these little bitches. Don't even give them their time. Nutword over there on his channel crying about his parent neglect. Then he deletes every fucking video. He's scared to death to leave a video on YouTube. Why? I have no idea. Like, we can't watch your shit if you keep deleting it, dummy. What the fuck is the point of doing a show if you're gonna delete it, motherfucker? Every time. You feel me? But like I said, like, these bitches, bro, don't even waste your fucking time, bro. I don't want nothing to do with none of you fucking clown-ass bitches. I want to get a fucking girl that has a real caliber, you know what I mean? She doesn't have to be in school or none of that. She just has to have an individual mind and want to fucking help me and build and do something. You know what I mean? Like, fucking actually want to build and be happy. Like, you know what I mean? Like, I'm beautiful. My life beautiful. Everything about me beautiful all the time at all times. And all these bitches have to say is negative shit. And they never even met me and don't know me. Like, that's the craziest shit to me. But they all in fake-ass relationships. Why? I'm gonna tell you why. Because all these fucking bitches, especially Mexican bitches, insecure as fuck. And they always gotta have some fuck nigga with them who ugly as fuck and fucking short and disgusting and fat and out of shape. You know what I mean? Or some fucking bum who just sits there and pretends he's ghetto and they're all ugly and disgusting because they have no taste. They're fucking nasty. And you know why? Because they choose impoverished fucking trash. You know why they do that? Because they have no fucking self-worth or self-value, no confidence. They're completely insecure and they're pieces of shit. And when the real man like me comes around, the handsome fucking knight in shining armor, what any normal girl would fucking die for, nigga, and I've had bitches fight over me my whole life, literally. These bitches is back-ass words and live in a back-ass word society where their parents rape them when they children, right? And that's why all these bitches grow up to have this exact mental problem, MPD, because they all got child molested. It's all factually proven. I can prove it in court. All these bitches got raped by their parents. Facts, nigga. See, I'm gonna make a fool out of you people. I promise you, you will regret fucking with me, nigga. All of you fucking people, dog. I'm a real person, dog. You don't ever insult legends. Fuck out of here. And I'm telling you, these bitches, they choose fucking trash. And the reason they choose trash is because they hate someone like me. Because they jealous. See, a normal girl, everybody thinks a normal girl is going to want the best guy. And the guy who's strong and good looking and has a personality and a sense of humor and makes them laugh and is good to them and wants to do everything for them. Nah, not today. Today, you don't have women. They're all dead. You have bitches. That's all you have. It's the bitch-ass, demonic, literally demon-possessed people. There's no such thing as mental illness. There is only demonic possession. Everything in this realm we're living in is spiritual. So when you have these demonic bitches, you have to understand you can't conversate, at least around me or me hearing, like that's a girl because it's not a girl. So when y'all make up all these ploys like, oh, you know, she played you or she did this or no, bitches play themselves all the time. I mean, niggas play themselves all the time. Look at my label. I'm still the only one on my record label. I'm actively trying to sign people. Nobody wants to do it. Why? Because they all fuck up the opportunity. Or they don't take it because they're stupid. Because they'd rather hate. I don't understand why you'd want to struggle instead of fucking doing well and fucking getting somewhere financially and building. I don't understand why make music if there's a guy right in front of you that has the tools to help you and instead you'd rather hate on him than you're going to do that with anybody. Even if it's somebody of your own race, because y'all, you fucking niggers are racist fucking trash, so if it was a black guy, you might be a little more on it, but you still gonna do the same shit because it's programmed into you. That's what these people don't get. They all want to have this energy like, oh, we just hate on you, Tyree. Nah, these people do this shit with everybody in their life. Why do you think Jared333 got kicked out of his fucking grandma's crib, nigga? Because they don't want his bitch ass. Why do you think Nutword got sent to fucking Job Corps by his mommy and is whining about it right now on his show as we speak. Huh? Because they don't want you. So all these testaments these people made hiding about me, they're all fake. I don't have any children. I never got ousted by my family. Never got ousted by any race. Everything they say just makes no fucking sense. I never got jumped. I pulled out half of my tooth on my own. Like, these people are fucking nuts. And literally, they're sitting there and all they do is try to slander your name and then act like it bothers you or gets under your skin. I don't care what you say, because nobody watches you. Nobody real is going to believe you. I promise you. If there's anyone who will listen to you, they're fucking dog shit. You know what I mean? So like I said, I mean, Jessica Metz, that's perfectly fine. Like, you can marry a mediocre guy, you know what I mean, and have a mediocre husband. What the fuck would I care? But you talking about me, I ain't talking about you. I like, you go to her channel right now, she talking about me for some odd reason. You know what I mean? I don't even know you. Like, this is weeks after the fact of what you talking about, and you now talking about, oh, you know, I cut off all contact. You lame as fuck then. I mean, you just lame as fuck. Like that, maybe that's your bitch's problem, that all you bitches want to sit there and keep acting like you some kind of prize or something. Like, you bitches is ratchet trash bitches. Don't nobody want to marry you. Jesus Christ, bro. I mean, you look like the fucking cartoon dancing egg that dances in the old cartoons with the Susie Q shit on their head. Y'all remember what I'm talking about? That dancing egg bitch? That's what you look like in the mirror. Fuck is you talking about? I don't want your bitch ass. I'm just trying to fuck. I'm trying to beat everything in sight. You know what I mean? Like, I didn't know that you're fucking engaged or whatever the fuck you are, and nor do I fucking care. You know what I mean? That's your fucking business. My business is try to bang everything in sight. You know what I mean? So, like I said, I just think it's hilarious how everyone got something negative to say, but they all pussy. Everybody claim they hate me, but they all fans. Like, the shit just weird, my nigga. Jared333, I just exposed. It's Jared666. I exposed him, number one, for picking on fucking young girls. He's cyberbullying young girls. That's a crime. So we could get you on charges for that, Jared. Straight up. We can get you on actual charges for that, smartass. Keep wanting to fuck with me? You sure you want to go against me, buddy? You know? Fucking moron. So, he's sitting there doing that, and then what else? And then I exposed him because he on his fucking channel literally begging for $1.50. He said, I need $1.50 to pay for something. No, nigga, you need anything to eat. Just like your fucking faggot brother. Your brother's gay. He sits there and looks like fucking Yoshi in the face singing gay-ass songs.
My love, love, love.
With a fucking dude who fucking looks like Uncle Howie and shit from Ill Bill. Jesus Christ. You couldn't make this shit up. These people are hilarious. And nigga, you might as well be wearing a skirt. Talking about you gonna fuck something up and you gonna beat it, beat this and that. You better hit that bag a little harder, nigga. I'll tell you that much. Cause you lie. You ain't quick enough either. Jesus Christ, bro. It is fucking insane. So like I said, man, when these bitches play their games, let them do what they do. You know what I mean? Everybody wanted to jump on the same boat. The other fucking bitch up there, the fucking Jennifer Soto or whatever the fuck. That fucking whore got put in her fucking place fucking with me. Who else wants it? Huh? You a weird-ass bitch, fucking broke-ass, begging fucking druggie, sitting there trying to raise money off a motherfucker, giving him a hard time when I don't have no fucking kids and you came online and lied. What the fuck is wrong with you? Who does that? Anything to fuck with your life. You not having a hard enough time, we gonna try to fuck up your life. I will never forget that shit, bro. Nor will I ever let up. Fuck out of here. Clown. So she got put in her fucking place, and then she wanted to sit there and say some dumb shit and talk about, you know, Ashley got those balls and sitting there working with those people. Like, bro, Ashley don't have nothing over here. at all. What Ashley did is played herself, fucked up her whole life, had the chance to have everything and have a beautiful life and be good.